what we know is that this virus is in the same family of viruses like SARS. So it is akin and about 80% genetically similar to the SARS virus. We know now, based on some of the transmission data from China, that not only did the virus jump from an animal reservoir into humans, but there is sustained human-to-human transmission, and that's been documented several times over now, including in a hospital setting with healthcare workers. Every day, we're learning more and more and more. Obviously, because this is a novel virus, and even though we've been to this rodeo before with MERS and SARS, there's still so many unknowns. This is the protein that is on the surface of a coronavirus, and it is the protein that the virus uses to attach to the cell and then enter the cell. What a mRNA vaccine is we're essentially delivering the genetic material. So we're delivering the messenger RNA that encodes our mutated novel coronavirus spike. The messenger RNA will tell the body to present this spike protein, and the body will respond by creating an immune response. And hypothetically, if all goes well, then that immune response will then be able to see a novel coronavirus before a person gets infected and prevent that infection. We started this collaboration with Moderna because we wanted to utilize our antigen concept, so our vaccine concept, but deliver it via their platform. So what that means is that we take our sequence from the VRC and we give it to Moderna, and Moderna develops the vaccine. And all of these things are things that we've done a lot, actually, with MERS and SARS vaccine concepts, including MERS mRNA. So we know what types of immune responses we're looking for in small animal models. And so we will be testing, evaluating those immune responses, and then we will be establishing a clinical trial. It would be the upwards of a year before we have data from those types of studies that would support a vaccine that is licensed for general use.